Hi all. Today we are discussing about the Laplace transform of derivative of a function. That is, we have a function f. The derivative of that function is df by dt. Then find out the Laplace transform of df by dt. So we can start it from the basic formula of Laplace transform. What is the basic formula? 0 to infinity e raised to minus st f of t dt. The basic formula for the Laplace transform of a function f of t is 0 to infinity e raised to minus st f of t dt. Here in the place of f of t we have df by dt. So it will be df by dt dt. Okay. So we can integrate it by parts. That is, first function into integral of the second function. So first function e raised to minus st into integral of the second function df by dt integral will be f of t. Okay, limit 0 to infinity minus integral of the derivative of first function, that is e raised to minus st derivative, that minus is e raised to minus st into integral of the second function df by dt integral, that is f of t dt. So on applying the limits, we are getting here first limit, upper limit. So it will be e raised to minus infinity. So this term will become e raised to minus infinity is 0. So this term will become 0 minus lower limit, that is e raised to 0 1 into f of t, that is f of t at t equal to 0. So this will become 0. 0 minus f of 0 minus this minus into minus is plus s into integral e raised to minus st, limit is 0 to infinity, e raised to minus st f of t dt. What is this function? Integral 0 to infinity e raised to minus st f of t is the Laplace transform of f of t, which that we can write as f of s. So the Laplace transform of df by dt will be s f of s minus f of 0. Okay, so this is the Laplace transform of the derivative of a function. Okay, then what will be the Laplace transform of the second order derivative, d square f by dt square? Okay, how can we find out this? This we can find out Laplace transform of d by dt of df by dt. That is, what is Laplace transform of df by dt? S f of s minus f of 0. Therefore, here we can write it as s f of s. F of s is the Laplace transform of ft. Here the function is df by dt. So, f of s here is Laplace transform of this function, that is df by dt minus f of 0. F of 0 means here our function is, what is our function here? Here our function is df by dt. Okay. So what will be f of 0? F of 0 will be df by dt at t equal to 0. So this we can write it as df by dt, we can write it as f dash t. At t equal to 0, so if this f of 0, here it becomes f dash 0, where f dash is the df by dt at t equal to 0. So this will become s into Laplace transform of df by dt, that is s f of s minus f of 0 minus f dash 0. F dash is the first derivative. And this will become s square f of s minus s f of 0 minus f dash 0. So this is the Laplace transform of the second order derivative. So we can continue the steps like this. So we are getting what we got as the Laplace transform of df by dt is f of s minus f of 0. Now Laplace transform of d square f by dt square, we can write it as, or we can write this as Laplace transform of f2, okay, f2t, that is second order derivative of this function, is equal to what we got, s square fs minus s f0 minus f dash 0. Okay, on continuing like this, we can find out the next order derivative Laplace transform too, that is Laplace transform of d3f by dt3. Laplace transform of third order derivative, we can write it as f3t, that is f3t means it is the third order derivative of the function f of t. So third order derivative, if we continue in the same pattern, we will get this as s3f of s minus s square f of 0 minus s f dash 0 minus f double dash 0, where f dash 0 is the first order derivative at t equal to 0, f double dash 0 is the second order derivative at t equal to 0. Similarly, we will get l f 4 0, that is fourth order derivative as s 4 f of s minus s 3 f of 0 minus s 2 f dash 0 minus s f double dash 0 f here, okay, minus f triple dash 0, where triple dash 0 means third order derivative at t equal to 0. We can write it as f2, this is f2 0, this is f20, this is f30, that is third order derivative, okay, or three primes. So on, if we can make a general formula here, Laplace transform of the nth order derivative of a function will become sn f of s minus sn minus 1. Here it is f of s, after that it will start with the f of 0. One f of 0, after that it will be derivative, that is s n minus 1, the power is decreasing, so it will be n minus 2. Okay, then it will start the from the first order derivative at t equal to 0. Then it will be s n minus 3, I am not writing, it will continue as s n minus 3, f second order derivative at t equal to 0. And it will go like this, and the last one will be here, if it is fn 0, it is f3, last one is f2 0, f4, it is f3 0. If fn, the last one will be fn minus 1 0. And just before the term is s coefficient. So this will be s, f, this n my 3, this is 2, so this will be n minus 1, this will be n minus 2, 0. This is the general formula for the Laplace transform of the nth order derivative. Or we can write it as s n f of s minus, it can also write it as minus sigma k equal to 0 to n minus 1 s raised to n minus k minus 1 f of k 0. Okay, where f of k 0 is the derivative of the function, kth order derivative of the function with t equal to 0. Okay, this is the, in this way we can find out the Laplace transform of the derivative of the function at any order. Okay, we can see one numerical. If f of t is equal to sin t by t, then find Laplace transform of f dash t. Okay, f dash t is the first order derivative of this function. Okay, so how can we find out this Laplace transform of the derivative of the function is equal to, yes, first order derivative is s f of s minus f of 0. Okay, so what will be f of, so we have to find out f of s and f of 0. Okay, so what is f of s? F of s is the Laplace transform of sin t by t. Okay, what is Laplace transform of sine t by t? Here, this is the f of t divided by t. When a function is divided by t, we can use the integration property of Laplace transform. We had seen in the last video. So this will become, what is the integration property of Laplace transform? Laplace transform of f of t by t is equal to integral s to infinity f of s ds. So it will be integral s to infinity f of s is the Laplace transform of the function. What is the function here? Sin t. So Laplace transform of sin t ds. What is the Laplace transform of sin t? That is sin a t is a by s square plus a square. Here a is 1, so 1 divided by s square plus 1 into ds. Integral s to infinity 1 by s square plus 1 ds. What is the integral of 1 by x square plus a square dx? That is tan inverse x by a. So here we can write it as tan inverse yes, by a is 1, so tan inverse yes, with the limits s to infinity. Okay, so we can write it as, on applying the limit, tan inverse infinity minus tan inverse yes, and tan inverse infinity is pi by 2 minus tan inverse yes. What is pi by 2 minus tan inverse function? That is cot inverses. Cot inverse, yes. So we got the f of s. Now we have to find out f of 0 too. So what will be f of 0? F of 0 is the sine t by t function at t equal to 0. Or that is, we can write it as at means limit t tends to 0. The t is tending to 0. Sine t by 2. This, you know, the limit theta tends to 0. Sine theta by theta is 1. So f of 0 here it becomes 1. So we can find out the Laplace transform of f dash t as s f of s is cot inverse s minus 1. Okay, s cot inverse s minus 1. Okay.